You can't get away from the fact that you're going to need to know something about the electrical aspects of model railroading. In this video, I'm going to show you the basics of electricity and what you're going to need to get by in model railroading. By no means is this an all-inclusive explanation of the principles of electricity. I'm not an electrical engineer. I've studied electronics. I've been an electrician in my earlier years. I'm retired now, but I'm going to tell you how you're going to get by with the basic knowledge of some of the principles of electricity in this video right here. So let's get started with it right now. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And one of the main things that you're going to need to know about is how these locomotives operate on the track. And you're going to need to know just a little bit of the principles of electricity and electronics in doing so. And I'm going to show you that here. And we're going to go through all this stuff right here, right now. So let's go and get started with it. Most of the manufacturers take care of all the hard parts in the locomotive. They put all the electronics in there, and the decoder manufacturers and everybody that makes the little gadgets like those little things down here from Digitrax. They take care of all the complicated stuff, but you still have to connect those to your railroad to make the thing operate. I'm going to teach you Ohm's law. I'm going to tell you a few other things. I'm going to show you in another video how to use a multimeter, and it doesn't have to be like this. This is a good one. You can get any multimeter, but that'll be another video besides this one here. But I'm just going to go through the principles of electronics, electricity, go through Ohm's law, and some other little things on here, how to hook up switches, terminology, and all the little things that you need to know when you're looking at some of the diagrams that they have for these items, and everything else that you're going to need to know about electrical components. First thing we're going to talk about is Ohm's law. Now, this little chart right here, this little pie chart there, that's a little bit complicated, and that goes into really great detail. But what I'm going to do is just go over the basics of Ohm's law, and we're going to talk about voltage, current, and resistance. And that's the three factors in Ohm's law. Voltage equals current times resistance. Plain and simple. And this goes back to the math classes you had long, long time ago, saying, what am I going to need all these formulas for? Well, anyway, here it is. You're going to need it for finding decoders. If your locomotive isn't listed for a specific decoder, you can find out what decoder you're going to need by how much amperage your locomotive draws. Let me turn this thing around so we can go on the whiteboard so I can give you a little demonstration of what we're talking about here. It's right over there. I'm going to be using this board right here so you could see what I'm talking about. That is Ohm's law, and that was created by George Ohm a long time ago. E is voltage. It could be referred to as potential, electromotive force, a lot of different things depending on what school you went to. I is the current, R is the resistance, and they're measured in volts. E, voltage, volt, I, current, amps, R, resistance, ohms. You're going to see this diagram a lot about DC, about hooking up your track. These two red lines right here are your track, and these two blue lines here are your leads going to your track with a transformer there. Now, this is just like DCC. These are your feeder wires right there, and you're also going to have your bus wires down here. So that's the same thing here. You got your track, you got your feeder wires right here, and then you got your bus wires right here. And then somewhere along the line down here, you got your command station. Or if you're doing DC, you have your transformer right there. So basically, this is what you're going to be looking at for the very first time whenever you're hooking up your tracks, and you're going to wonder what is going on, what are all these things about. Okay, whenever you have a little dot right there, that means that's a connection. You'll see that a lot. When you have a little thing that jumps over a wire here, that means they're not connected. Okay? I'm going to show you a few more symbols that you're going to need to know. That could be a battery, or that could be your power source. Battery or power source. That's a symbol for a fuse. Now, I'm not an artist here, but that's a symbol for a resistor. That is a symbol for a single pole, single throw switch. This right here, the bottom one right here, is a single pull, double throw switch. Now comes the fun part. Now, if you want light bulbs or something like that, anytime you have anything, it might be shown as a circle. It could be a light bulb. It could be a motor. And they'll usually identify it with a letter inside of it of what it is, and it's the same thing as resistance or a resistor, because that's going to be something in the circuit that you're going to be dissipating the power from your battery or your power source. In these drawings right here, I have a power source, a battery, a switch, and a lamp. I'll use the lamp as that little thing right there. It could be anything. It could be a diode, it could be a LED, it can be a motor in there. If you want an LED in there, we could put a little resistor in there too, but to simplify things, I've made it as a lamp. Also, this drawing right here is the same as this drawing right here, and is the same as this drawing right here. We're assuming that this is where you have additional items on a line, and here's a switch, here's the lamp, and this goes to ground. So all three of those are identical. It's just different ways of showing the same thing. Now, you may see batteries like that, okay? Each one of these is a cell in a battery, okay? But as far as model railroading goes, you'll probably only see one, or you may see it as a coil on your transformer. Like that as your power source, because there's going to be another one up here. Now let me see if I could do that, okay? That is a transformer. This is your primary, and this is your secondary. Okay, you might have 120 volts here, and you might have 12 volts here. Now, there's other circuits in there that would change this 12 volt, because this is AC. That's AC. But then you'll have some other circuitry in here with capacitors, diodes, and maybe a little voltage regulator to make it DC. I'm going to show you another thing that you might see in a drawing, and I'll explain this to you. If you ever see this by itself is a single pole, single throw switch. But when you put another set of contacts in there and you get a little dash line in between that, you won't see the box around it, but I just put the box there so you know that it is one unit. But that is a double pole single throw switch. That means there's two contacts in that switch. This is what a double pole double throw switch is going to look like in your diagram. You're going to have two different terminals for each wiper on your switch, and it's connected internally. So what you're going to have is six terminals, and this is what the bottom of the switch is going to look like. These right here in the center are going to be these right here. And then the two outside ones are going to be these two right here. This is like the wiper right here, and it's either goes this way, and when this one goes this way, this one goes this way. They're both connected. And so when you flip the switch the other way, these two are connected. So that's a double pole, double throw switch. Just to make things a little bit more clear, a single pole, single throw switch, this is just the side view of it, and you'll have two terminals on it. And this is what it looks like in the wiring diagram, okay? And a double pole, single throw switch is going to have three terminals on it right here and these two terminals here. So you'll be able to use one's normally closed and one's normally open here. So, and you'll be able, when it switches, it'll switch down that way. So what this is right here, you'll see on the switch itself, it may be real small on there, but it'll identify them with a C, an NC, and an NO. Most of the switches will have that on there. So you know which contact is normally closed. That's when it's just sitting there, and you may have like a little thing on here, and then there's another wiper, an actuator thing, and then it'll push this thing in to switch between normally closed and normally open. It'll switch that down to here. So this one becomes closed and that one becomes open. So there you go with that. Also, you have a normally closed switch. Okay. On a normally closed switch, you have continuity going through there. So this is normally closed. This is a normally open switch. Most of them are normally open switch. It could be a push button, okay? And you'll have a little deal. And I'm not the greatest artist, but there's a push button. And you have normally open push buttons and normally closed push buttons. On the normally open push button, you have an open circuit there. So when you push the push button in, it closes the circuit. When you have a normally closed push button, you have continuity normally. And then when you push the button, you break that continuity and it opens up. So that's the difference between normally closed and a normally open. Here's just a little review of Ohm's law here. Here's a little pyramid with it. E equal I times R, I equal E over R, and R equal E over I. Don't forget to subscribe and ding that bell. That's a sorry looking bell right there, but you get the idea. So you could be notified whenever I have a new video coming out. And like I said, I'll have one on the meter, and I'll have more videos coming out on principles of electrical on your model railroad. So take a look for it. I hope I covered enough in this video for you to understand the basics of electrical design and principles in model railroading. If I missed anything and you have any questions, don't forget you could leave a comment down below and ask me anything you want, and I'll answer it for you. And I'll probably do a Q&A on it for you. So, don't forget Ohm's Law, the little pyramid there. And I'm taping this with my phone, so I can't show you the little apps, but there are apps, and I'll have the links for them or the description of the apps that you could use, where you could do a lot of calculations and a lot of different things for your model railroad on there. So check them out. Here we go, Tom's Trains and Things. Check out all my other videos that I have up, and check out my webpage. And if you would like to support this channel and my webpage, go to Patreon/TomKovichak.